Cause here was just a
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go.
This and I, can you just make it snow in California? I'll even settle for it.
Hi guys, it's Chloe, and guess what I'm filming today? Well, you already know. Oh my god, I can't contain my excitement. I can't contain it, even though I'm Jewish. I got all the decorations going on. We got it all behind me. I got it all. I'm so excited right now. So I'm literally so excited for this video. I worked so freaking hard on it. I also need a winter series name, so please comment below any clever names you may have for my winter series. Anything you think it should be, because I am literally have no idea what to call my winter series. I don't want to keep you guys waiting too long, so let's get started with the video.
Whenever I decorate my room for a season, I always start with my bed because that makes the biggest difference, I think, and it is what your eyes always focus on when you walk into a room. You do not have to go out and buy all new expensive bedding. I'm using this fuzzy blanket I already had from Target, and it completely changes the vibe of the bed and makes it a lot cozier. I also picked up this super cheap kind of holiday sweater looking blanket from Target, and then I also picked out some pillows. I got two pillows from Target for about $15 together. They were on sale, so that was awesome. I'm putting those on my bed, as well as some other pillows I already had that looked a little wintry, and that is it for the pillows. I decided to make my own pillow out of a pillow I already had for my bed, which leads us to the first DIY of this video. Oh my god, that voice cracked out first. Anyways, let's move on. So for this DIY, you'll need a pillow. I already had this one and I decided to recover it. You will also need two fabric colors. I decided to cover my pillow with this cool plaid fabric, which I got from Amazon. So I'm going to be measuring my fabric to the pillow and just hot gluing 3 out of the 4 sides onto it. I'm leaving one side open like a pillowcase, so when the season's over, I can just slip it right off. And I did something very similar to this for my fall DIY room decor, if you want to watch that video. And then I decided to add a polar bear to the center of it by printing out a polar bear silhouette, cutting it out, and tracing it onto a white fabric. This made it so much more wintry and so cool, and the polar bear really popped against it. Once I had cut it out, I'm just hot gluing it on, and that is it. It is literally my favorite DIY ever, and it is so simple to do and looks really professional, and that concludes our holiday bed. Yeah, all I need. Above my bed, I just hung up this really adorable garland, which leads us to DIY number 2. And for the DIY garlands, you will need some mini logs. These are actually coasters from Michael's Craft Store. You will also need some sticker letters and some string. And this DIY is pretty self-explanatory. I'm just going to be sticking each letter onto the log. I spelt out winter, but you could spell whatever you want, but I thought winter was really cute scent to put. Once the letters are all spelt out, I'm going to be putting my letters logs onto the string, and I've found that using tape was the easiest. Instead of glue, I just smothered on some duct tape and I was good to go, and I put them on for all of the letters. And that is it for the DIY. I hung it above my bed and it is so adorable and really cheap to make. This year, I decided that I wanted to make my nightstand look super cute. So first off, I swapped this really colorful candle for a candle for Target from only $3. And then I just switched out my painting with this adorable frame, which has to be my favorite DIY. And it's a really cute Tumblr photo frame, which leads us to DIY number 3. And it is so cute. I'm so excited to share it. You will need a frame. This is from Michael's Craft Store for only about $5. You also need fairy lights, which I got off of Amazon.com for super cheap. You also need festive photos. I just printed mine from Tumblr, but feel free to use your own. But I thought these were super cute. I'm first spray painting my frame red, but that step is optional. And then I'm going to be stringing my fairy lights through it, and I'm making 3 rows to hang my pictures on. Instead of using string, we're replacing the string with this, and it is so cute, and I think it looks so awesome with the lights. Then I'm just going to be adding my pictures in and deciding where I want them and attaching them. I used washi tape to attach them to the fairy lights, but I would recommend clothespins, but since I didn't have them, washi tape was fine, and that is it. It is literally the cutest thing ever. The next area that I decorated was my tabletop area. I decided to switch out all this wintry room decor with three DIYs, which we are going to make very shortly, and it's going to be so exciting. The first step on our tabletop decor agenda is this breathtaking firefly jar, which is literally the coolest thing ever. And I'm obsessed with it. All you're going to need is a mason jar, and you will also be needing some fairy lights for this DIY. You can get these on Amazon. You can get them primed for only like $5, which is amazing. That's how inexpensive mine were. So all I'm doing is I'm going to be filling them into the jar and just filing them in, and that is literally it. It is more of an idea than a DIY, but I still think it is the coolest thing ever. Just watch as I turn off the studio lights and look how amazing it is. Will be the perfect gift. Let us know, let us know, let us know, let us know. In California, this gonna happen to the very. It is now time to make DIY number 5, which is this Let It Snow sign. You will need a wood board. I got mine from Michaels for, again, super cheap. You will also need paint colors of your choice. I did the classic wintry blues and whites, and you also need paintbrushes. I'm going to be first coating my board with some blue paint because that was my background color. I ultimately decided to go back and spray paint it a more turquoisey color because it was more opaque. Then I'm going in with a pencil and I'm just sketching out Let It Snow to kind of like make sure I have it all good before I go in with the paint. Then I'm going in with my paint and I'm writing Let It Snow in cursive. For the snow, I'm doing a huge S, N, and W, and for the O, I decided to make it a snowflake, and then I'm just going to be scattering out little snowflakes all over it and making it a very cute little board. We are now at my final official DIY of the day, DIY numero 6, which is this ornament tree, and it is so cute and cool. You'll need a cone. I got mine from Michaels. Again, I love my Michaels. I also got this huge set of a variety of ornaments for very cheap at Target. All I'm going to be doing is hot gluing my ornaments onto my cone. You can also use some other type of very strong glue, and I'm doing this all the way around my cone, starting at the bottom, working my way up. Super simple and self-explanatory, but it turns out so cool and sophisticated when you're done. I kept my desk very, very simple. I decided to fill a mason jar up with some candy canes because I just love to snack on those in the wintertime. And I replaced my Eiffel Tower with that. And I also added a little jar from last year next to it. I replaced my jar of Starbursts with these really cute little bows that I found at Target. And I thought it was really festive and also really cute. And to finish off my desk, I just added a little bow on my painting, and that is it, literally. But the prettiest. For the finale of this video, you will be coming along with me as I create my long-awaited Jumas tree, which I've been waiting to do forever. I've always wanted to make a Jumas tree in my room, and I finally am. I got this tree for only $20, so I thought, you know what, why not go for it, pursue my dreams. I'm wrapping it with some lights that I got for very cheap, and then I'm going to be accessorizing it with some ornaments. This one is from Urban Outfitters. It is a C. I also got this one at Urban Outfitters. Hey, oh, why you wearing that to walk out of my life? Hey, oh, even though it's over, you should stay tonight. Oh, baby, let me love you goodbye.
enjoyed this video. And if you're not subscribed already, be sure to click subscribe right down below, because I post a new video every single Sunday. I'll see you guys in next Sunday's video. Bye!